Most people go to Hokkaido in the winter for skiing, snowboarding, or the Sapporo Snow Festival. However, in this video, I want to show you some of the other things you can do while you're there. From the scenic sights, to the delicious local cuisine, fun activities, culture and history, and the best days. So come with me and let's explore Hokkaido. In early December, I flew from Tokyo to Hokkaido's largest airport, the new Chitose Airport. From there, you can hop on a train or a bus to Sapporo, Hokkaido's capital city. Or a great side trip from Sapporo is this hot springs town that we went to. Now we're in Noboribetsu. It's a hot springs town and we're gonna go grab some lunch. Hokkaido is famous for Genghis and that's what we're gonna have. So let's go. And isn't it pretty, the snow? It's like Christmas in Wonderland already in early December. Genghis Khan is a Hokkaido specialty consisting of grilled mutton or lamb. The dish is always prepared tableside on the convex-shaped grills, and guests are served with sliced meat which can be plain or marinated, and are then encouraged to grill the meat themselves along with various vegetables such as onions, cabbage, and bean sprouts.
まずこの鍋なんですけども、周りで野菜を焼いていただいて、上でお肉を焼いてもらう形のものになります。で、上で焼いたお肉の肉汁が下に焼くと垂れていって、そして野菜がそれをスープという形で美味しく食べていただきます。タレこちらになるんですが、こちらここに直接かけずにタルタルの方でつけて召し上がりいただきます。はい、ありがとうございます。楽しみです。
Usually beef, especially wagyu, is not on the menu when you go to a Genghis Khan restaurant. However, since the town next to Noboribetsu is well known for their wagyu, you could also choose to have wagyu here at this restaurant. It is believed that Genghis Khan was named after the founder of the Mongol Empire. Although there are many theories about the origin of the name, the most popular say that it was influenced by the convex shape of the grill, which resembles a warrior's hat, and the fact that Mongolians were well known for favoring sheep in their diet. After lunch, you can take a stroll around the town and check out some of the sites which display the volcanic activity. There are spouts and blowholes everywhere with over 10,000 tons of water gushing out from different hot springs every day. This water is used to supply the hotels in the area.
So I've been to Beppu, which is in Kyushu, but I actually prefer this one better because it's more natural and like outdoor, whereas at Beppu you have to pay an entrance fee and go in to see it.
We're in heaven. There are a few other natural hot springs you can go see. However, on this day, the path was closed due to the snow. Afterwards, we headed back to the shopping street where we had lunch and went into a cafe to warm ourselves up. We found this cute cafe that sold Japanese pudding. They had the classic pudding, but also ones with really interesting toppings like corn. Let's just say it wasn't my favorite flavor, however, it was definitely interesting and unique to try. When they serve it to you, they actually put it in this onsen basket, which I found really cute. If you have time, I would definitely recommend to stay in Noboribetsu for one night and enjoy the onsen and the food at a Japanese inn.
Good morning, guys. Do you hear that noise behind me? Yep, it's like a bug. So this morning we're gonna start it off here at Noboribetsu Off-Road Park.
これ日本の中で一番ガチですか?ガチガチ。ガチと言われてるんですか?だから、こういう施設の人が練習に来るぐらい。Guys,
I just got changed. I'm in proper gear now. I'm ready to ride the buggy. Except, fun fact, I don't actually have my license, so I'm not sure how well I'm gonna do. I'm a little bit worried, but we're gonna practice first and then try the real course. So, wish me luck!
ですね。あそこ看板にコースの絵描いてます。黄色、青、赤と3つあるんですけども、
まず黄色いこの目の前のオーバルのコースで、基本練習、独特の難しい乗り方があります。基本練習します。で、練習が終わりましたら、今日はちょっとコンディションの関係でね、いきなり赤い上級コース行こうと思ってます。
お、
ただ右が前タイヤで左が後ろタイヤ。
Guys, I swear it was hotter in real life than it looks here in the videos. I think what I found the most difficult was actually steering. It was a bit hard to turn, and if you didn't concentrate or balance your body weight right, you would just end up in the ditch, or the part where no one's made any tracks.
How am I doing?
Next, we took the train to Upopoy National Ainu Museum and Park. You can also reach the museum from Sapporo Station in around an hour. Upopoy National Ainu Museum and Park is an open-air museum and park showcasing the history and culture of the Ainu, the indigenous people from mainly Hokkaido. The main exhibition building had this beautiful 180-degree view where you could see all of the park, including the lake that the museum is situated by and the traditional Ainu houses. Apparently, during the colder months, the lake freezes and professional ice skaters have even skated on it before. I went at the beginning of winter in early December and the lake was already starting to freeze a little bit. The thing I liked the most about this museum was that it was very interactive and you could learn about Ainu culture by not only looking and walking around the museum, but trying out different activities. I tried out the 30-minute cooking class and the teacher taught us how to make dango. Foods like this were made in the past only during special ceremonies, so it would always be a treat when you could eat them every few times a year.
アイヌ語でニヌーム、くるみのタレになります。こっちはアイヌ昆布、昆布ですね。
The dango was chewy and firm, so I really liked that, and I really loved the walnut topping. You can also watch a traditional Ainu performance. At Upopoy, they try to revive traditional dances based off of old records, and they incorporate that with modern technology to showcase the traditional songs and dances. There are also audio guides you can get so you can understand what's happening in the performances. Next, we headed to the traditional Ainu houses and tried out some of the activities there. We gathered around the hearth and listened to the tales and songs from the everyday lives of Ainu people in the past. It was really interesting and also really touching when the lady started telling us about her personal experiences growing up with Ainu grandparents. You can also learn how to play a traditional Ainu instrument called mukuri, and it's like a mouth harp. There were also craft activities you could try as well, like the sewing one here. I also practiced my bow and arrow skills and I managed to catch a deer. No, I'm just joking. You can also try venison at the restaurant in the museum. I ended my trip in Hokkaido by staying at this beautiful hotel by the beach. この部屋も海が見えるんですか? Okay, let me play you a song.